I'm here to introduce our speaker today, Dr. Yasha West.
2 and 3, who forgives all of our sins, all of our iniquities. He even heals us. He redeems us and have nerve enough to crown us with his loving kindness. Science and medical professionals agree and sounded the alarm to take care of our bodies. We have been warned about cholesterol, basic stress, all kinds of substance abuses that destroy the body. We're overweight, we have heart problems, all due to not following God's free diets. So, Dr. West, where are you going with this? Understand this. 3 John, 1st chapter, 2nd verse says, "Beloved, I pray that you may prosper in all things and be in health, just as your soul prospers." So, health is at the top of the list. A person's mind and spiritual nature and body are all interrelated and yet independent. What affects one affects the other. When the body is misused, the mind and the spiritual nature cannot become what God's plan or ordained us to be. The mind should tell the body what to do. So, where are we going? Just hang with me. So, why did God give health rules to his people? The Lord commanded us to observe all of these statutes, to fear the Lord our God for our good always, that he might preserve us alive. You can find that in Deuteronomy 6:24. You shall serve the Lord your God, and he will bless your food, your bread, and your water. Repeat after me. God will bless.
God will bless.
Your bread.
Your bread.
And your water.
And your water.
He also says, and I shall take sickness away from the midst of you. That's in Exodus. God is the giver of life and has given us a manual to follow, which is God's basic instructions before leaving earth. There is a penalty for ignoring God's word, which will result in disease, twisted thinking, and a burned out lifestyle.
Yes, yes.
So following God's rule will result in salvation, yes, which is saving health, Psalm 67:2, and abundant life, John 10:28. These great rules are our shield of protection from Satan's trap. So let's move on to Matthew 5:17 and 18. We've all heard this before. Jesus says, "Do not think I have come to change the law, but I have come to fulfill the law. I tell you, until heaven and earth disappear, not the smallest letter, nor the least stroke of a pen, will by any means disappear from the law until everything is accomplished."
Yes, yes.
There's a great controversy about the food law. Some say that we should follow God's law. Some say that law was changed. Some may say in Acts 10:12, when Peter was on his balcony and had a vision, that he had a vision and said, all kinds of footed beasts of the earth.
Yes.
the Lord said, rise, kill, and eat. That's the first voice of God. Which would indicate that God is giving his permission to eat all kinds of food. But read on a little bit further. Acts 10:15, and the second time that God's voice came to Peter saying, do not call anything impure that God has made clean. So what did God make clean? The key is clean. God has already declared in chapters 11 of Leviticus and Deuteronomy 12 and in chapter 14 of Deuteronomy what was clean and unclean. God does not change his mind. God is perfect. Psalms 18:30 says, this God, his way is perfect. The word of the Lord proves true. He is a shield for all those who take refuge in him. Since everything God does is perfect, he can't make a mistake, because a mistake would be an imperfection.
Yes.
Got awfully quiet in here. If God's dietary laws were practiced in our society today, they would bring health, peace, happiness, and prosperity. God says, see, I have given you every herb that yields seed, every tree whose fruit yields seed. For every tree of the garden you may freely eat. The diet God gave the people in the beginning was fruit, grains, and nuts. Vegetables were added later in Genesis 3:18. So, like I said before, there's a great controversy. And this sermon is to get you to thinking. These dietary statutes are applied for all people for all time. The animals that are unclean, remember in that Acts, God said, anything that's clean, you do eat. So in Leviticus 11 was designed by God to be scavengers and are not fit for human consumption. The Messiah's sacrifice does nothing to change Yahweh's basic fact on creation. Biblically, clean meat, fish, fowl, meat are listed in Leviticus and Deuteronomy. There are 10 kinds of meat that we can eat. That's beef, roebuck, hog, mountain sheep, lamb, deer, antelope, ox, goat, and buffalo. 32 different kinds of fish. I won't go through all of them. But I was kind of upset with God. When I read some of these things in here that I love, like oysters, like shrimp, and like like catfish, I say, wait a minute, God, wait a minute, wait a minute. But these are scavengers. There are 11 kinds of fowls that we can eat. Dove, pheasants, geese, pigeons, quail, turkey, chicken, duck. 14 kinds of unclean. Listen clearly. Listen clearly, because when I was doing the research on this sermon, he shook my world. He shook my world. There are 18 kinds of unclean fish. Like I said before, oysters, lobster, squid. I don't know nothing about squid. But all of these are scavengers. There are 14 kinds of unclean meat. Now, remember, don't shoot the messenger.
Should have brought it after Thanksgiving.
I know, he gave it to me. 14 kinds of unclean meat. And the first thing on the list was ham. Ham. Possum, shanks, hyenas, rabbits, snakes, lizards, horses, dogs, rats, spiders, mice, and on. 18 kinds of unclean fish, like I mentioned. 9 unclean fowl. So unclean meat, fish, and fowl are scavengers. And the classic example I want to lift up to you that you need to go do the research, Dr. West didn't say this, but research has. Why should you avoid pork? Don't shoot. They are considered the garbage and waste elementation of the farm, often eating literally anything they can find that we don't even think about. This includes only bugs, insects, and whatever is leftover scraps they find laying around, but also their feces, as well as the dead carcasses of sick animals, including their own young. At least one farmer went out to feed his pigs one day in 2012. Literally speaking, the pigs had breakfast on him. The first reason that it's so bad to eat pork is because of that digestive system of the pig. The pig digests whatever it eats rather quickly, in a matter of 4 hours. Many of these toxins remain in its system to be stored and in its fatty tissue ready for consumption. When you consume pork meat, you too get all of these toxins that weren't eliminated from the pig. Something to think about. According to the World Health Organization, processed meats like ham, bacon, sausage causes cancer. The International Agency for Research on Cancer actually classifies processed meats as carcinogenic, something that causes cancer. Research found that consuming 50 grams of processed meat each day raises your risk of colorectal cancer by a very significant of 18%. Increased cancer risk from bacon and other processed pork. Noticing a theme? Processed meat is considered to be food, items like ham, bacon, sausage, hot dogs, and some deli meats. Those are mainly pork-derived food products. So how much processed meat is 50 grams? According to the research, 4 strips of bacon, likelihood to equate to 9%, increases cancer. What is in conjunction with all of that? The pig is consumed with swine flu, is another virus that has made the leap from pigs to human. The pig also harbors influenza, or flu viruses, can be directly transmitted from pigs to humans, from humans to pigs, and from humans to humans. Pig carries many viruses and parasites with them, whether by coming into direct contact with them through farms or eating their meat. We put ourselves at higher risk of getting one of these painful, often debilitating diseases. Not to mention to put our bodies on toxic overload. So the final thought on why you should not eat meat, pork. What you choose to eat is up to you. Me, myself, God has raked me over coals very good. I choose to stay away from unclean meat, fish, or whatever. The reasons discussed here are just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to eating unclean animals and your health. Better meats to eat? Let's look at some meats that are protein rich and known to be health promoting. I'm talking about high quality protein that's not only tasty, but very nutritious. Grass-fed beef has a higher level of vitamins and is disease-free. It is also higher in minerals like calcium, potassium, and magnesium, high level of cancer-fighting CLA, and other good fats like omega-3A. Grain-fed cows are more likely to have added hormones and antibodies. Bison meat has a rich flavor, even healthier than grass-fed beef. It's a great source of lean protein, less calories and fat than beef, with a rich flavor. Another one is lamb, meat of the young sheep. It helps prevent obesity. Lamb meat contains slightly higher fat content than beef. However, the fat available in lamb is that it's healthy and it contributes to good health. Since lambs are fed with grass, they have a significant amount of omega-3 fats. For the fish, we call for wildlife. Just like with meat, avoid farm-raised fish, Yasha. Wild-caught fish does not contain antibiotics or pesticides and are higher in vital nutrition. Wild-caught salmon, which is extremely high in health, in heart, and anti-inflammatory omega-3 fatty acids, selenium, niacin, vitamin B12, phosphorus, magnesium, and vitamin 6. Farm fish have high concentration of antibiotics, pesticides, and lower levels of healthy nutrition. This is up to you to make do your own research. What is it that you're eating? There is a saying that we are what we eat. Do your own research carefully. Consider what the Bible so many years ago has warned us. And then make your own educated decision about what you choose to eat. What are you eating? You are what you eat and an extension of what you have eaten. What you choose to eat is up to you. Myself, I have chosen to change my eating habits very significantly and to stay away from any foods that has been declared unclean by God. God will and has taken care of you all of these years. When we don't know any better, we're not accountable. But now you know. I know. And I am paying attention to the warning because we don't know when the enemy will use the very thing that we eat to destroy us. Amen. God will take care of you. Won't you stand?
Amen.
God has taken care of you. God is your provider. He doesn't do anything that's going to hurt you. He tries to preserve you, constantly warning us that we have to pay attention to what His Word says. In Jesus' name.